emotional intelligence, comprehensive leadership of the self, groups, and organizations, authored by Robert Cooper and Ayman Sawaf. Rather, we are looking forward to much more than that, controlling emotions, events, and fragrances from them, and the matter is not limited to merely suppressing some of them, but extends to them and directing them in their subjects properly, and to the extent required. Rather, as a manager and businessman, you are responsible to a large extent for the feelings and emotions of those working under your supervision. Who among us can claim his ability to complete such a task that always remains incomplete, awaiting completion in stages of emotional control? The attempts of philosophers and psychologists in the field of human feelings tell us that there are four stages during which the individual rises gradually until he reaches the peak of emotional control, which is as follows. The first stage, the stage of emotional literacy, before any of us begins to deal with his feelings. He must first understand the sources of these feelings and the way they compete for physical and physical means of expression. Here, a person is committed to realizing the depth of his feelings at the stage of their birth inside him, and before they emerge in the form of behavior, and in this way we are able to gain destiny. The sensitivity required to deal with our feelings and emotions is that understanding yourself does not mean knowing your habits, but rather knowing the amount of buried treasure and the ferocity of the complete beast within you, and being able to deal with it as intelligently as possible. Learn the language of feelings so that you can deal with your feelings honestly. You can use the following steps. First, write a diary about the past. The goal of this diary is to free you from past memories by editing and understanding them so that they do not leave negative accumulations or side effects. Second, write notes about the present whenever you feel a feeling that is stronger than you are or something that you do not understand. Grab a pen and paper and try to analyze your feelings. Third, write down your expectations for the future. You will spend January 4th of an hour each morning writing down your expectations about the upcoming meeting with the manager, the amount of work required of you today, or the developments of a situation you faced yesterday. Warnings: the purpose of writing is not to record positions and opinions, as this is dangerous and also useless. The real goal is to train you to be aware of your inner feelings, so do not dwell on the narration of events, but pictures of your feelings, and the difference between what is happening in reality and what is happening inside you. Don't try to understand or organize your thoughts. You should not seek to formulate it in a logical or sequential form in books. Whatever means to you the moment you feel it, this type of writing is called emotional or automatic writing. There are those who find in automatic writing an alternative to realistic self-expression, and so they continue to write their thoughts and describe their feelings on papers only. So do not forget that writing memoirs is just a stage that you must overcome, so do not continue writing your memoirs after a period of 3 months after this period. Collect everything you wrote and reread it quickly. Keep your diaries in a safe place until you get rid of them. After a while, you will learn to deal with your feelings directly and in the moment they occur without any problems. Paper and pen, prophetic energy. When you understand your feelings, and when you review your diaries, you can determine what turns you on or what frustrates you. You will then be able to realize your true goals and objectives, and then you will see your future as an understandable task that can be implemented in stages. Without tension or fear, and thus you have a kind of telephony in the endeavor and life. That telephony is the reason for the generation of what is called psychological energy, as net energy is that concentrated emotional charge that pushes and urges you to strive in one direction rather than another to achieve one goal without another, and for this nuclear energy cannot be generated by those who do not set their goals. Nuclear energy needs to focus on a certain direction, and it will fade away if it is scattered in conflicting directions. The sincerity of emotion and twisting ideas, the heart never lies, and this is on the mind that can provide you with arguments and justifications in favor of several conflicting goals at the same time. As for the heart, it only casts its vote in favor of one cause that it deems just. Take, for example, the feelings of anger. Many people believe that feelings of anger must be demonstrated without being presented with the slightest right of expression. But the issue is, what do we do with feelings of anger? Rather, the issue is, why were these feelings generated as well? Feelings of anger are generated when an individual feels that one of his principles or basic rights is being threatened. Here, anger may be the best thing we have. If you do not show your ability to be angry, the other party may interpret this as a green signal to continue in his behavior, but the generation of anger within you is the red signal that warns him not to continue. Because of anger, the rights of many people will be lost. Before you deal with your feelings, you must understand and decode them. Next comes the emotion management stage, where the goal is to understand feelings and emotions and gain the ability to manage and direct it. How can you control your feelings the moment you are born? Managing momentary emotions to manage your momentary emotions successfully? You can follow the following three steps. First, stop to recognize the type of emotion, instead of trying to deny or suppress it. Secondly, explain the cause of the emotion as a kind of feedback to you about the situation you are exposed to, by asking yourself what principles and values you seek help from in this situation. Thirdly, direct the generated energy to the direction you deem appropriate, by asking yourself what is the best course of action in this situation, and what are its side effects later. Fourthly, train yourself to practice this heartbeat until it becomes a habit for him. This method teaches you to restrain momentary emotions and to stop expressing them the moment they arise. You should then focus on the third step. The third step depends on a perspective view of the side effects that could result from your emotional reaction. The question you ask is, what is the most appropriate action? What are its future dimensions? And they lead to the following skills. Neuroscientists have discovered that the cells responsible for carrying out the process of future thinking are not present in the brain alone, but are also found in the nerves that produce feelings. There is a great similarity between the formation of brain cells and emotional neurons, and this indicates to us that the heart and feelings have their exact calculations just like the mind, but many of us are afraid of being led by our feelings, for nothing but because they do not know how to explain it or deal with it. With this layer, our feelings throughout our lives are an unknown area that we know nothing about, and we do not know how to benefit from it between the mind and the heart. Anyone who visits great people and their way of life will find that they did not depend in any of their decisions or actions on one mind or one heart, but rather they always used the mind and the heart together in a balanced mixture and in an admirable way. Decisions issued by the mind are based on the logical analysis of external information, as for decisions issued from the heart, they depend on memories of past experiences, aspirations, and dreams, so it makes sense to consult your heart in all your decisions, especially those related to the future, no matter how practical they are. Emotional leadership. The most important thing in the life of the organization is to maintain relationships and communications between employees, customers, and managers. You should not try to manage every individual in the company just because he is one of your employees, but you must understand the feelings and emotions that this individual generates within you. If you learn to manage these feelings, you will know how to deal with this person. Emphasizing the role of feelings in dealing with employees does not mean abolishing mental control or limiting practical considerations. Rather, all it means is extinguishing a new emotional dimension in the relationship between management and employees. It is a mistake to understand emotion as an alternative to reason or to understand an event as an alternative to analysis. What is intended is to enhance administrative and practical practices by adding an emotional and emotional dimension to them. Therefore, we need to achieve a degree of balance, which requires conscious daily training, and this takes us to the next stage of emotional intelligence, the second stage, the training stage. Feelings and emotions, and your emotional strength means degrees of influence, and the difference that your presence can make. Whether on the individuals in your environment or on the course of things, emotional intelligence and coldness, the concepts of emotional intelligence and coldness should never be confused. The first is based on understanding internal feelings towards others, while the second is based on ignoring and suppressing these feelings. self with others, while coldness works to exclude any relationship with others, and it is a kind of preoccupation with the intention alone, and they lead to two different results. Emotional intelligence teaches how to adapt to others and establishing conscious relationships with them, while coldness is a self-closing in on itself, which leads to deepening its inability to establish conscious or successful relationships with others, and so they take emotional intelligence to a path that is completely different from the closed circle in which they reap coldness, confidence, self-confidence, and the trust of others in us is one of the remains that we acquire during our interactions with others, and it also needs training to reach the point of balance. The price of trusting too much is regretting, and whoever does not give his trust enough is tormented, and to know the degree of trust that you enjoy in others, you have to move to the third stage of emotional intelligence, which is the third stage, the stage of moral commitment, and in it you realize that you must have a degree of moral integrity that emanates from within you without hypocrisy and falsehood, in order to win the trust of others, and moral integrity is based on four basic elements. First, distinguishing between right and wrong. Second, your heartfelt belief and rational understanding of this distinction. Third, uphold the truth at all costs. Fourth, alter ego by supporting the truth and convincing others of it is beyond moral integrity. There are four moral deities, which are the conscious personality, which distinguishes between right and wrong, but does not take any positive steps. In this, Belle Ashkett is a committed woman who distinguishes between truth and falsehood with her heart only, and takes positive steps to live according to principles. Ha, but it stands helpless in the face of new moral dilemmas, the innovative Oriental one that understands the truth with her heart and mind, and can deal with developments in reality, so the forms of right and wrong change in front of her, without losing her balance or her ability to distinguish and act positively. Subliminal. The fourth stage is the stage of innovation and confronting new problems. The main factor at this stage is the clarity of the emotional vision. At this stage, the individual feels that they are interacting with all the parties and things in this world and outside it, where you can control your enthusiasm, your return, and your emotional energy to the degree that allows you to adapt to the different variables effortlessly. Here, you always take the direction of the future for you and discover growth opportunities now. She is comfortable and goes through new experiences without fear and with a strong desire to overcome obstacles and deal with alternatives that she has never seen before.